So let's give a warm welcome to our next speaker, Xavier, who will be talking about environment modules.
Thank you. So good morning, everyone. It's a real pleasure for me to be there at FOSDEM this year to talk to you about modules. Modules, it's an open source project that can ease your day-to-day work when you have to deal with a terminal shell console. And this project is also referred as environment modules for disambiguation. So let's introduce myself. My name is Xavier Delaruelle. I am modules project leader since almost 2 years. I work at CIE, which is a large French research institute. And more specifically, at CIE, I work in the high performance computing division. So, typically, when you work on a console with a shell terminal, you have one initialization file you can use to set up your environment properties. But with the regular facilities provided by shells like Bash, KSH, and so on, it's kind of complicated to know what are the stuff that have been configured, and it's also kind of hard if with the same user account you need to work on various aspects on various projects. So here is a quite simple example where you have a production setup that requires you update some of the default environment variable, but if you want to work on a test setup to evaluate new version of a software, for instance, you need to switch from one to then edit your configuration file. It's not much convenient. So modules, it can help for this use case. It provides a module shell function that updates the current state of your shell, the environment variables, aliases, and so on. It does that by evaluating module files that represents some environment change set. And once a module file is loaded, it can be tracked, so you know what is loaded, and you can unload them. You can remove the change you have done to your shell. So, small example, here we want to use an AppW tool. It's not there by default, Bash cannot find it, but by module loading this module file about this software, then afterward we get the tool in the path. So how does it works? First steps, the module files. Module files, they are scripts written in TCL that express a change to a user environment. So you can write a full TCL scripting language, and on top of that, we add some specific function to handle environment stuff. For instance, for the AppW module file, we add to the path variable with the appnpath module file command the specific binary dir for this software. Then after the module file, we have the module cmd.tcl script. So this script, it takes a command, it takes a shell, and for this shell, it will produce code that represents the change to apply to your current shell session. So here in this example, we call the module cmd.tcl script to get a bash output that represents the load of the AppW module file. And the important part, among others, is we see here the path variable. It is updated with the binary directory for this application. And the last part is the module shell function. And this shell function, it just calls for module cmd.tcl script, and it gets the shell output, and then it evaluates the shell output. And by doing so, you update your current shell session. So that's the basic principles behind all of that. So When you start to work with module files to update your environment, you can use catalogs to organize these module files. And then you can enable these catalogs with the module command. Then afterward, you are able to search through these catalogs for a certain module file. And you can also load, unload these module files by just referring by their relative small name. A module file, you can show what it does, so it can express you what are the environment changes that will happen if you try to load it. Here, for we want to see what app X is, so we see the whole definition for the app X module file. And module file, they can express dependencies between themselves, because, for instance, to use an application, you may need to load prior a library. So that's why app X defines. And when you try to load app X, the module command automatically will handle the prerequisites. And it will first load lib A to then load app X. And as a resulting environment, we have both module files loaded automatically for you. You don't need to wonder. You can, with module, dump your current environment state. This is called collection. You just module save to a name, and there will be a collection of that name that will be registered in your user environment. And this collection, you can show what it does, and it is a set of module commands that, when they are applied, restore the previous environment you had. So then you can switch from one environment to another. For instance, if you want to switch from a production setup to a test setup, let's say you have one production collection and one test collection. So if you are in a test environment and you restore the prod collection, it will unload all the production module files and then load it will unload all the test module files to load then afterward the production module files related setups. If you are a system administrator, modules, it can help you to satisfy your users. When you have to deal with one shared system where you provide access to many users. Because in this situation, you always have one group of users who want a software A in a version and a second group of users who want the same software but in another version. So there is conflicting needs, but they access the same resources. So you cannot use for them the standard installation path. So modules, it can help you to give access to very large catalog of products. So if you have a very large number of users, you will end up with a very large number of installation of different versions for the same software, and then it applies for hundreds, thousands of software. And modules, it can help you to provide access for all of your users to these software catalogs. In this situation, you will also end up with users using different shells. Some will use Bash, others will use Fish or TCSH. And it can be very hard for you as a system administrator to provide guidelines to your users because, for instance, to update an environment variable, you do not do it the same way for the Bourne family shell than for the C family shell and for Fish. But with module, with the module command, it's always module load to enable something. So you can simplify, you can write shell agnostic guidelines for your users. Currently, modules support most of the common shells out there. SH, Bash, KSH, ZSH, all the C shell family, and the Fish and CMD for Windows. And you can also call for modules from a scripting language like Python, Ruby, Tickle, or Perl to get access to your software catalog through your script. You do not see that very well, but it represents the readers of the documentation of modules all over the world. modules is quite used out there. In fact, this is a project that is nearly 30 years ago. And it is mainly used in the scientific computing world, where scientists access supercomputers. So they have all access to the same machine. So module in this field is the standard way for scientists to access large software catalogs. Currently, the project has a nice development pace. There are multiple releases each year. The software is well integrated in all the Linux distribution. You can also reach it from Homebrew on Mac OS X, and it's also available on FreeBSD. And if you follow this link to the ripology.org site, you can see quickly all the versions available on all the OSs. So current development trends, the work currently is focused on ways to automatically solve and apply the dependencies between the module files. The idea there is to follow the same principle we can find today in a software packaging tool like DNF or APT. There are other very cool stuff to work on, like providing cache for module files to speed up the search of thousands of module files. It can be also very interesting to expire module files after a given date. Module files, today, they are scripts written in TCL. It could be quite convenient for people, for newcomers, to be able to write these module files in Python, because people better know Python today than TCL. And we can think of a lot of new commands like stashing and stash pop environment through collection, like you can do when you work with something like Git. So contribution, they are really welcomed. There are very nice stuff to work on. You can also come to the mailing list with your own ID to share. Good thing to know is that there is a very large non-regression test suite for this software. Currently, approximately, there are 8,000 non-regression tests, so it provides a very large, very good coverage level. We are currently at 99% of coverage. And all of that is integrated in continuous integration against Linux distribution, OS X, FreeBSD, and even Windows. So that's it. Thanks for your attention. And if you have any question, feel free to shout.
So we do have time for one or two questions if you want to ask Xavier. Otherwise, he'll be available outside of the room as well. Oh, we have one question. Go for it.
It seems that a lot of things can be done also with containers. So what's the advantage of modules?
The question is, as of today, there is this container fashion, so what modules can be used for? In fact, containers, they shift a bit the way if you, and they are very nice if you want to provide a specific setup with one application and one version. But as soon as you need to provide multiple versions of the same software, so you can, of course, handle multiple containers, but if you just want to maintain one container, you can have in this container all your application installed and use module to switch from one version to another. So container can be a way to simplify, in fact, your work. But as soon as you need to provide a complex matrix of version and dependencies, modules can still be there to help, even in a container world.
And I guess you mentioned scientific computing and things like that. And there are also a lot of old installations where you can maybe run a Docker because kernel version is not too old or something like that. So maybe it can be used.
Of course. Of course. Even if in this HPC world, there is also a good trend to have support for containers. So. Other question?
Great. Nope. Then, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we'll leave something to you.
Oh, perfect. Thank you.